just recently very people have asked me what tools and spares I carry in the Land Rover. Some people like to carry nothing at all but their AA membership card. I like to carry a goodly amount of spares and tools, but restricting it to what I can fit in the vehicle's toolboxes and things that are potentially useful. It's really easy to carry far too much. But anyway, this is what I carry. Very rarely need anything, but it's there. If it is, if you go a bit off the beaten track and you've got a problem, it's quite nice to be able to sort it out. So we'll start with electrical bits. There's a pack here of general electrical connectors, obviously a crimp tool with it. In there we've also got various distributor spares, springs, and a rotor as well. New rotor arms are a good thing to have. Glass fuses, blade fuses, all the types that you'll find in this vehicle. We've got a relay, spare relay for the headlamp circuit, obviously not standard. Piece of wire is always useful. Four bulb kit, including ones for the dashboard lamps, because I believe if your charge light bulb blows, that's it for the charging circuit. So quite good to have one of those. Pair of headlamp bulbs, starter solenoid, and we have the old ignition coil which lives in here. It's still good, but they are one of those things that can just fail. It's worth carrying in my opinion. Got a spare hub seal, exhaust hangers, there's Jubilee clips in there, spare spark plugs, springs, all little odds and sods, prop shaft bolts, that kind of thing, which just occasionally that little tub has got me out of trouble. Important thing to carry though is these lock washers for your hubs. If you have to reset a wheel bearing anywhere, you'll want new ones of them. OTV sealant, quite a handy thing for roadside repairs. Cable ties, never carry too many of those. Spare fan belt is a must. And I've got various oddments of gasket material. A good selection of hose. I use biofuel hose for the fuel pipes on this vehicle, which is what all the major manufacturers use now. It's very good stuff actually. It's quite okay with E10 if you should be using that. Water hose. Spare slave cylinder, clutch slave, only because I had one of those fail out on the road while towing a trailer and it was very inconvenient and I could actually have sorted it at the side of the road rather than waiting half the night for recovery. Spare fuel pump, again just an easy thing to have, it's so easy to change one, but they very rarely do give any trouble. And a spare distributor, rather than carrying lots of spares, you can change your distributor in minutes, so it's easy just to pop that in and off you go again. So really a few simple spares could save you a lot of trouble. And also fuel pipe clips, and there's some gaskets, so hub gaskets that live in there for example. And that's pretty much it for the spares department. So I've got a fairly comprehensive toolkit, but I've kind of carefully worked out what I need, so I've got just the minimum to get me out of trouble really. I've got a breaker bar here for wheel nuts, 27mm socket on that. That clips out of the way on the bulkhead. Tire pump. Issue carburetor toolkit, simply because I run that modification and there's very little to go wrong with them. But it's nice if you can at least change the fuel needle valve if you have to. That's the only thing that's ever given me any trouble. There's little else to go wrong. But all the tools are there to adjust one. So we've got a goodly selection of spanners, but really just the sizes that I need. So there's most of those are like combination spanners. The slimline ones are really good. These are all old, good quality spanners as well. That's a brittle one, for example. So there are AF sizes, and then there's Whitworth sizes in there as well. Half inch AFs, good for your gearbox filler plug, for example, 9/16 AFs for prop shaft bolts. So you want to look at what sizes you actually need to carry. We've got Whitworth spanners, punch, a chisel is really good, cold chisel. If you have to change or adjust the wheel bearing, you can use these to knock back the tabs on the big lock washers. Likewise, we have a Tommy bar there, which is for the hub bearing nut box spanner. Pliers, scissors, more punches and screwdrivers. Yeah, reasonably comprehensive toolkit, but not excessive. And I find a tool roll is a great way to keep it, because it doesn't all rattle about and you can stash it just about anywhere. I've got these storage bunkers in the vehicle. They're mostly empty. They're really for camping gear and so on. I find they work well for me because they're quite lightweight, and stowing things in the back of, I say lightweight, relatively speaking, they're timber. They're easy to remove. Things rattling around in the back of old Land Rovers is always a problem. It's always difficult to know where to stash things, so they're very good for that. Obviously, a little vice on there, handy. In this one, at the moment, lives socket set, AF, metric and Whitworth sizes in there. The old slimline socket sets are really good. They'll stash just about anywhere. Tow rope. Only ever once or twice needed a tow rope, but it's quite good if you can get your mates out of trouble as well. And a folding shovel. Take this out in a second and you'll see what else lurks beneath. So there's also that old ammunition tin, and the heavier items go in there. So apart from the basic tools, we have a spark plug spanner. That's purely for my stationary engines when we're out at shows, so it's just convenient for it to live in here. I've also got this half shaft nut spanner. 109s have a sort of castellated round half shaft nut on the front, after 1980, I think. This being an 82 build, we have one of those in the toolkit, which I made. Handy to have if you've got to adjust the wheel bearings or take the free wheel hubs off or anything like that. That is the hub nut spanner, big box spanner. There's a impact version of that. I'll tell you what size it is, 52mm. I've just found that's useful for cracking them off. That just lives in here, really, just for convenience. Same with the crank pulley one. Doesn't need to be in the toolkit really, but it's there. Somebody keep it. I've got sockets that fit the suspension bolts. They are a useful thing to have if you're green laning or on any rough tracks for any length of time. One for the U-bolts. Yeah, so there's suspension bolt sizes. And then there's the Allen keys there for adjusting the selectors on the Roma drive. And one's a drain plug for that as well, I believe. And here we have the rear toolbox. I think most 109s have this. Starting at the back, there's a pair of wheel chocks under the grease gun. They're useful if you get stuck somewhere and you've got to change a wheel. Perhaps a rather precarious position or a steep bit of road. I've actually used those. The grease gun, obviously for the prop shafts. There's a little socket set in there, a little cheap Halfords one, which is ever so useful. I found this is a great way to store oils for topping up. You don't ever need a gallon can. You shouldn't do unless you're travelling a very long way. So these little litre plastic jerry cans are brilliant. So they fit right down in the toolbox. So I've got one full of antifreeze mix, coolant, 2050 engine oil, EP90 gear oil, and a bit of DOT4 brake and clutch fluid as well. I carry a 6-ton Shelly jack, bigger than the standard Land Rover one, but it has a much higher lift. Quite a useful thing. And if you get stuck while green laning, sometimes you actually need to lift the vehicle rather than just try and tow it out, and that is a brilliant thing for that because it's got a wide base. So that brings me to another point. There is a piece of plywood in the bottom of this toolbox is a spreader plate, like inch marine ply, which is really useful in that sort of situation. Also a oil can there for topping up, funnel, and there is a little electric tyre compressor in there, but it's mainly there because it's useful for blowing up camping beds and that sort of thing. Just a handy thing to have, really. One thing that I haven't shown you is there's a high-vis jacket in the vehicle. Obviously this vehicle being the colour that it is, if you get stuck somewhere at night, perhaps you've got no lights, some sort of failure, you at least want a high-vis jacket, and you can either tie it on the vehicle somewhere or wear it yourself. It is a good thing to have. Vehicle lighting and reflectors have come a very long way, suffice to say. Anyway, I think that pretty much covers all the basics. There's some stuff there that's not strictly necessary, but I found over the years that these are useful things to have if you're travelling a bit further afield. A lot of serious Land Rovers just potter to the shops or the pub, but mine does go a little bit further afield, and sometimes for a week at a time or so. So it's peace of mind as much as anything to have these things aboard. Like I say, it's good to limit it to what you can fit in the toolboxes. You know, you want to think about what you can actually sort out at the side of the road or once you've made camp somewhere. So that's how I look at it. Anyway, hope that's been of use. Probably the only other thing to say is carry some good lights. Haven't shown you, but because it's kind of difficult. That doesn't live in my toolkit, but I've got some pocket-sized LED torches and magnetic lights as well that easily stow in the toolkit. So that's another thing that comes highly recommended. Hope the video helps, and thank you very much for watching.